to the Prophecy Club. Let's talk about Trump. You know, normally in doing these broadcasts, in most cases, I make a bunch of notes so I can smooth through it. And for various reasons, I want to say the right things and I want to avoid the wrong things. And also, it reduces the number of edits I have to go back where I fumble and stumble or have to cough or something like that. But I just want you today to just pull up a chair, okay? Let's just sit down, have a cup of coffee around the couch, kind of you and I. I just want to talk to you about something. I just want to have a conversation with you. Lindsey Williams and I are good friends, and I mean good friends. And he calls me, and sometimes I call him, and there's been times we will talk for several hours at a time. And it is just amazing how our hearts are knit together. And brothers and sisters, I believe most people whose hearts are not knit together with this broadcast have probably already turned the channel. So I believe probably most people that are listening to this, especially if you went to prophecyclub.com and downloaded this broadcast, you've been listening for a long time. So for this particular broadcast, I'm going to assume that we don't have any unsaved people. We don't have any new people listening to the broadcast. For this particular broadcast, I just want us to just sit and talk for a minute, okay? Just pull up a chair, have a cup of coffee. Let's talk a little bit. Now, I want to talk about Trump. I want to talk about how what is happening right now may be our Jeremiah 51, verse 9. It may be our chance to be healed. Now, you remember, the angel that spoke to Dimitri said the fall of America would start with an internal revolution started in America by the communists. Now, it is my opinion that Hillary and Billary are communists, as well as Sanders, communist, okay? My definition of a communist is basically someone that wants to put all of the money into one big pot and then everybody pull out of that pot as is needed. Now, that may sound good in theory, but in practice, it's not so good. And all you have to do is look at the communist nations around the world and look and see how they're doing. Now, sometimes a communist nation calls themselves communist, such as with the Chinese, but they're actually using capitalist techniques, and that's the reason they have done well. Now, in the case of China, you remember the angel spoke to Dimitri and said God would raise up China and Japan and many of the nations that would go against the Russians. So the reason that China and Japan are doing so well, in my opinion, is because this is part of God raising them up. I mean, the Bible says that God raises up and God puts down and he makes alive and he heals. I mean, it's all in his hand. Now, back to the point I'm trying to make. Jeremiah chapter 51, verse 9 says, "We would have healed Babylon, but she would not be healed. Forsake her and let every man returning to his own country." What if Trump is our chance to be healed? I don't have a thus saith the Lord on this. I don't know for certain that that is. And for this particular broadcast, again, I'm assuming that you and I are friends, and I'm not going to do a whole lot of disclaimers. Again, this is not a broadcast for the public, though it's going to be broadcast on all the normal channels. This is a broadcast for just us prophecy students. And so if you haven't been listening for a while, you might not want to listen to this one. What if Trump is our chance? In other words, what if right now Americans really should be fasting and praying for Trump, for his safety? No, I know he's not a good Christian like we would like to have, but he may be God's man for this hour. It may be that this is the guy that God has put into this position for this particular time. Okay, now why do you say that? Well, for one thing, he got $1 million as his inheritance. He took $1 million and turned it into over $10 billion. That sure sounds like God to me. And why would a guy that is already doing really well risk everything, all of his wealth, all of his name and everything, why would he risk all of that to run for president? It just doesn't make sense. So I'm just wondering if this is God's opportunity to America to be healed. In other words, what if what is really supposed to happen? What if we're really supposed to be fasting and praying? so that Trump really will be protected, really will be the nominee, really will get into the White House and serve his 4 or maybe even 8 terms and really turn this nation around. We would have healed Babylon, but she would not be healed. What if the American Christians, by turning away, and please, I have never made a broadcast like this. If you've been listening for a while, you know that I'm sort of like not so much into politics, and I'm not even too much into news, although we talked about it a lot. I mean, I'm really a Bible prophecy guy. I'm really a watchman, okay? What if we're really supposed to be fasting and praying for Trump? I'm about to say something that I cannot prove, and I certainly can't tell you where I got this information, other than I have received numerous emails talking about this. What if we could move forward, if we could look at Judgment Day, when I assume we get to see everything done all the way back to Adam, everything that's not washed in the blood of Christ. Assume we get to see a replay of what was done on earth, because the Bible says everything done in secret would be shattered from the rooftops. Everything hidden would be made open and manifest. Everything that is, except for our sins, and they are washed as far as the east is from the west and thrown into the depths of the sea. Thank God. Thank you very much. Anyway, so what if when we see this replay, what if God shows America that here it was, I had this all set up. If you had just fasted and prayed, if you just repented enough, I was going to put Trump in and I was going to kick out a lot of the evil. I was going to turn America around. America would be healed. Now, why do you say that? Well, again, here's this information I cannot prove. And so I'm going to go ahead and give you a disclaimer right up front. What I'm about to say, I absolutely cannot prove. As a matter of fact, to a certain degree, I'm not convinced I totally even believe it. But to the degree, what if it is true? I understand that there is an entire new set of government all ready and set to go. There are some people that say that people in high places, many of them, are about to be arrested. I just got an email where one said that some 600 people in high places are about to be arrested. Now, to the one degree, I want to say, you know, this is foolishness. This is rubbish. But on the other hand, I want to say, what if it's true? What if God has an alternative plan to quickly turn this nation around and heal this nation if we would only fast and pray that it would happen and Trump is only a part of it, a large part of it, but a part of it? I have heard that there is an entirely new, quote, Republic of the United States, all set up and ready to go. Off on, I don't even know how much I should say here. I don't even know how much I believe of all of this. But nevertheless, we're talking, okay? We're just prophecy students talking here. Supposedly, this, quote, Republic of the United States is all ready to go, and it has been established off on sovereign Indian lands up in the Nevada area. At least that's what I've heard. Now, I'm not trying to say it's true, but what I am trying to say is, what if? What if there are things in place where America could be healed? Try to imagine the Bible, not just prayer, but the Bible put back in schools. Try to imagine evil cast out of high places. Try to imagine what if it really could happen, if Trump really got into the White House and really discovered such evil and began to clean it out, the nest of cobwebs, the nest of evil going back hundreds of years in this nation, families and bloodlines, and just clean it all out. Would that not be wonderful? The thing of it is, I have to wonder. I have to wonder if Jeremiah 51 verse 9 is not taking place right now. What if this is our chance? What if this is our chance to see our nation healed? Now, I know what you're saying. Are you trying to say you're for Trump? Okay, all right, well, let's just talk about that. When the 17 candidates first presented themselves, I thought Huckabee would be my choice because he's probably the closest to pastor, probably the best Christian one. But of course, we all knew that he would never be elected, because if Jesus himself was running for president in the United States of America, nobody would vote for him. Very few would. You know what I'm saying? Simply because as soon as you say you're a Christian, especially a pastor, then you're off the ballot. Okay. I mean, because we're going to have anything. We'd have a Muslim, but we're not going to have a Christian. We'd have a Buddhist. We're not going to have it. We'll have an atheist. We're not going to have a Christian. And that's, unfortunately, the lion's share of the attitude out there. So then it began to narrow down. I began to think, well, you know, I mean, I as we got up to about the top four, I made the remark to Leslie. I said, well, actually, any of those four would certainly be a vast improvement over what is in the White House now. But then as the debates went on and as I listened to more, then one day in the early phases, Leslie popped up and says, oh, I like Trump the best. I said, Trump, really? So I began to listen more and more. And then I began to see that what Trump stood for is diametrically opposed to the New World Order. None of the other ones stand up against the New World Order. You take Cruz. Well, who is financing Cruz? He is not self-financed, so that means to a large degree he's bought and paid for. Trump is self-financed. I like that. Now, this is not going to turn into a broadcast trying to convince you to vote for Trump. But I am going to try to convince you to fast and pray that the right man gets into the office. And I personally, I mean, I already voted for him. And if I get a chance to, again, if there is an election in 2016, he's going to get my vote again. But why not Cruz? Okay. Again, I'm being open and honest here. Okay. This is a, have a cup of coffee. Do you need refill? Do you take sugar and cream in yours? Okay. I mean, this is one of those kind of, let's just talk broadcasts. Here's what I have against Cruz. I got an email. I can't prove it. I'm going to tell you right up front. But it said that his wife, Heidi, used to be a member of the Council on Foreign Relations. Coupled that with the fact that he, in one of his emails that I got someplace else, actually had him explaining why she was a member of the Council on Foreign Relations for a while. So how can somebody that's a member of the devil's house be good? And a person might say, yeah, but we're voting for him for president, not for his wife. Well, tell that to Clinton. Tell that to Bill and Hillary. Because to a large, I mean, you men out there, does your wife have anything to say with your affairs? Oh, yes, she does. So we got to look at the whole package here. The biggest thing I have against Cruz, I think Trump is right when he says, Lion Ted. When Cruz gets up there and says, well, you know, he doesn't want to debate me because he's afraid I'm going to cut him to pieces or some, that probably not quoting him exactly right, but you know what I'm trying to say. And I'm thinking, are you kidding? We'll be right back after this message. Order 2014 to 2021. It's the predictions of two cows and 13 modern prophecies. As Joseph interpreted Pharaoh's dream, I interpret these signs and prophecies to present a picture of what you can expect from 2014 to 2021. Now remember, all of this is in the mouth of two or three witnesses. The topics are September 25th, 2014, and how it starts the last 7 years of plenty. Then from the years 2022 to 2028 will be the 7-year tribulation. That's a very big statement. Then welfare checks will stop. Protesters start burning the cities. Martial law then declared. Obama stays in office. The Constitution suspended. Local militias formed to combat the Obama men. Gun confiscation is then ordered. That starts the internal revolution spoken of by Dmitry Dudeman. Then Russia attacks America in a surprise nuclear attack. Then Christian martyrdom begins. It's 2.5 hours of some of the most important information in the last 20 years of this prophecy ministry. Call 785-266-1112 or prophecyclub.com. It's called 2014 to 2021. Call 785-266-1112 or prophecyclub.com. Order today. The next speaker at the Prophecy Club will be Dr. Bree Keaton. Not only does she hold 2 doctorates, prayer walked in 40 countries, author of 8 books and DVDs, but this little lady was sent by God to the deepest, darkest jungles of the Congo, where she found, rescued, and led 60,000 pygmies to Jesus. Machine guns fired at her, machetes chased her, she was hunted like an animal, yet her prayers have kept her alive. Most Christians probably won't survive the coming trouble, but she has certainly earned the right to show you how to survive in her talk, Explosive Prayer Strategies That Work. Come and hear her free talk Saturday evening, April 9th, 7 to 10:30 at the Prophecy Club. She'll minister the following Sunday morning from 10:30 to noon. That's Saturday and Sunday, April 9 and 10, Prophecy Club, 2540 K Avenue in Plano, Texas. Learn more at prophecyclub.com. And now, back to the program. When Cruz gets up there and says, well, you know, he doesn't want to debate me because he's afraid I'm going to cut him to pieces or some, that probably not quoting him exactly right, but you know what I'm trying to say. And I'm thinking, are you kidding? It's Trump that slices and dices you. He's happy to do more debates. He just doesn't think there's a reason for them. And frankly, I don't either. I mean, he's already been through, what, 17 debates or something like that. And they've already asked him all the questions they're going to ask him. I've actually caught Cruz lying about four times. So that discredits him. And then I'm not trying to discredit the other ones, but I'll just simply say, as far as Kasich, no. Nice guy, but no. Well, one email I got said, you can tell who a person is by who attacks them. And I think I got this email, somebody forwarded to me something about Ted Nugent. And I guess he's some, again, I'm not much into politics. As you can tell, I don't follow this exactly detailed or anything. I'm a prophecy guy, okay? I follow the prophets. I follow the Bible. I don't follow the politics, so I'm not exactly pinpoint accurate on everything, but I think you'll get the point I'm trying to make. When we watched, for example, the three candidates being interviewed by Anderson Cooper, if you watched that debate here a week ago, Anderson Cooper was pretty nice to the other two. But when he got to talk to Trump, he would ask Trump a question. Trump would start into the question at about three or four words into answering the question. Cooper would fire another question at him. And he'd get three or four words into answering that question. He'd fire another one. He was beating him up with questions. Question, 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 question. And of course, I mean, I thought to myself, man, if somebody were to hit me like that, I mean, just question, question, question. I would have to say, whoa, stop. Hold on. What are you trying to do? Are you trying to trip me up? Are you trying to get me to say something that's not accurate and not really my heart? Okay, then hopefully he would respond, say, oh, no, that's okay, then let's make this deal. You ask a question, and I get at least two or three sentences to answer the question before you ask another question, okay? One question at a time. I'm happy to answer them, but one question at a time, and I get to at least two or three sentences into finishing the question before you hit me with another one. I'm not saying I have to answer it fully, but at least two or three sentences. You're not even giving me two or three words before you hit me another question. And then three or four days later, once again on the Communist News Network, we have Chris Matthews of Hardball doing exactly the same thing. With the other two candidates, he's fine. But when he interviews Trump, it's blast, 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 question, question, question. And I have to say, what sane person could even go through that? And I was amazed that Trump was as sane and as patient and as kind as he was. I think most of us going through something like that would probably make an error in judgment someplace along there, like his abortion comment that everybody's beating upon him about. Am I suggesting that you vote for Trump? I think if that's what you're hearing, I think you're missing my real heart. I shouldn't have to tell you to do that. I think that a person should see the spirit of a person. Like, for example, I shouldn't have to tell you that Hillary is a liar. I shouldn't have to tell you that. If you are a Christian, if you have the spirit of God in you, then you already see that. You shouldn't have to be told that Hillary and Sanders are communists. You ought to know that. You can see that. And I think you ought to be able to spot the spirit of Kasich and know that that spirit there is not the kind of spirit that I think God wants in the White House. And yes, I think that Trump, when he said 2 Corinthians, instead of saying 2 Corinthians, I don't know if you caught that comment, but he was reading something from the Bible, and this was two or three months ago, but he said 2 Corinthians, which tells you he doesn't know that much about the Bible, because you don't say 2 Corinthians, you say 2 Corinthians, okay? But it tells you, and he doesn't really know the Bible much, but his heart is to try to help this nation and to turn this nation around. He's self-funded, and people are not going to be able to control him. Do you think there's going to be any Democrats in heaven? I mean, if someone is for abortion, and some of the other tenets that the Democrats are for, you think they'll make it into heaven? They might need a pretty good ladder to get there. I say that kindly. I'm just saying that you should be able to see these guys' hearts. Now, as far as Cruz, I think he's bought and paid for. Special interests have their nooses around his neck. Though he might want to do something good, I think he's not going to be free to do it. Whereas the one person that stands out above the other ones that is free to do it, free to do the best thing, is Trump. But I think he may very well be our chance to be healed. So what do I suggest? I suggest that we all need to get into some serious fasting and prayer that Trump is protected. You remember Lindsey Williams was told by his elite buddy that the elite absolutely positively will not allow Trump to get in. And they have a plan of about 9 different options that they plan to exercise to keep him out of the White House, including the JFK option. They're going to do everything they possibly can to keep him out of the White House. But we as Christians have to know that the weapons of our warfare are mighty through God, to the pulling down of strongholds, loosing the angels to do warfare. We have to know that greater is He, the Holy Spirit, that is within us than he that is within the world. We have to know that our prayer, one, can put 10,000 to flight. So that means that when we pray in agreement, wherever two or more agree is praying for any one thing, it will be given them. We have to know that our fasted prayers are really, really powerful, which is why, by the way, I should throw in here, if you are not a member of our Fast Track team, let me suggest that you go to prophecyclub.com and sign up. You can drop it anytime you like. Essentially, what I do is every Tuesday, you'll get an email directly from me asking you to pray for this and such or that and such. And there's typically different things to pray for. We have in the ballpark of around 700 people that fast and pray every Wednesday for the things that I ask them to pray for. Now, we don't want to muddy the water. So when you fast and pray on Wednesday, we ask that you not fast and pray for everything around the sun, okay? Not a whole bunch of other ministries, a whole bunch of other things, but try on this one day to fast and pray and stick to primarily our ministry. And what we ask you to do is to begin your fast Tuesday evening at midnight and go to Wednesday afternoon at 4 p.m. It's not even a 24-hour fast, and I think we're going to be on the 465th week now. That we, as a matter of fact, there was just this past Christmas, I was going to give them a week off. And that night, God spoke to me in a dream and basically said, oh, no, you don't. We must have that fasting and prayer. And I really didn't realize it was so important, which is telling me that fasting and prayer may be the thing that's keeping this ministry going. Our ministry is not prosperous. It's not doing well. We're not growing. We're not adding a lot of stations. There's not a lot of new people tuning in, listening to us. I mean, I'd love to be able to give you those kind of reports. But the truth is, if America was a Christian nation, we would be giving those kind of reports because they would be receiving our message. But it seems like the harder our message is, the fewer people listen. And I say a lot of things that can cause a person to turn the radio channel. And I understand that, but I mean, I've got to say them. I've got to say what I believe to be the truth, and I can't be dictated by money or threats or promises or anything. I've got to be running after the Lord hard and fast, because like you, I want to hear, well done, thou good and faithful servant. And I'm willing to give my life for the Lord, and just like you. And so back to our point, Trump. Jeremiah 51 verse 9. We would have healed Babylon, that's America, but she would not be healed. I wonder, when we get to heaven, if we don't get to look back and say, wow, if we had just fasted, if we had just prayed a little bit more, if we'd prayed that Trump would get in, maybe that's what God was going to use to turn this nation around. Now, do I have a thus saith the Lord on that? No, I don't. But I'll tell you what, I've talked to, for example, Lindsey Williams. I've talked to several other people that, Pastor Massey, talked to several other people, and they all agree that that seems to be what is happening right now. There is a furor. There is a rising. There is an excitement. There is a turning to Trump for a candidate running for president in this nation like I've never seen in my 62 years here on earth. I've never seen this. And like he says, it's a phenomenon going on. What if, this is the question of the broadcast, what if this is our chance? What if this is our chance to get the Bible back in schools, prayer back in schools, the chance to get our jobs to start returning, to start setting things correct? And it seems like everything in America is to put us down. All right, now, prophetically, do I think Trump is going to get the nomination? From everything I know about Bible prophecy and from the modern prophets, I have to say no. Pastor Massey had a dream in which he saw, and he says this is not a thus saith the Lord dream. He says he does not consider his dreams to be thus saith the Lord. But he said he had a dream that Trump did not get the nomination, that he was very disappointed, and there was a lot of like chaos and riots as a result of it. Well, maybe that's exactly right on. Also, as I look into the future, everything from what Dimitri and all of the other 160 guest speakers we've had over the last 22 years, I do not see anything in the future that would indicate that something good would be turning America around. In Daniel chapter 7, we see the fourth beast is world government. The first beast is the English lion, and then the American eagle's wings, then the Russian bear, and then the Islamic leopard with the four wings and the four heads. Meaning that the thing that must fall before they get their world government must be the eagle's wings, because we see the eagle's wings in Daniel 7:6, but we do not see the eagle's wings in the beast coming up out of the sea, which is the heads, you know, the seven heads and 10 horns of the lion, and then the body of the leopard and the feet of the Russian bear. But there's no eagle's wings, meaning the thing that is holding them back from world government, the thing that is holding back their new world order, is America. So prophetically, America must fall. The picture I see is America must fall. I do not see anything that says Trump is going to get a nomination, Trump is going to get in the White House, Trump is going to turn anything around. But again, Jeremiah 51 verse 9 says, we would have healed Babylon, but she would not be healed. Now, I wonder is when we get to heaven, if he says, this was your healing, this was your chance, America. If you had got behind Trump, and if you had fasted and prayed, then I would have put the man in there without strings, that I put my will in his heart, and he would have turned America around. But you would not be healed. You would not back it up. It is amazing to me that so many people don't see that. I mean, just like we should be able to see the heart of Hillary, the heart of Sanders, I think we need to see that this may be the heart of God, our opportunity to be able to be healed. And in closing, I just want to say, it has been wonderful to sit around the couch, have a cup of coffee with you today. I look forward to doing it again. And I want to say thank you. Thank you for listening. Thank you for your support. Thank you for being there. Thank you for continuing to tune in and listen to what sometimes is a pretty hard message, sometimes a message that may, frankly, make me sound like a knucklehead. I understand that. But at the same time, I think in our heart of hearts, we know that this message is of God. So I just want to say thank you. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for support. God bless. Welcome to the Prophecy Club. I've got Augusto Perez on the phone with us today. He made a DVD a couple of years ago with Prophecy Club. Is America in the time where Babylon might be healed? Now, to tell you a little bit about Augusto, pastor 7 years, and he has actually been given 44 dreams and visions, which he covers on the DVD called End of Times. He's written 4 books, including the very popular Smile, Jesus Loves You. Topics on this DVD are The Great Shaking, The Coming Famine, The Glory Cloud, Coming U.S. Attack, The Great Darkness, Super Devaluation of the Dollar, Double Portion Outpouring, and How God Will Protect His Own. both DVD and book available for a gift of $40 at prophecyclub.com or by calling 785-266-1112. 785-266-1112. Okay, Augusto Perez, welcome back to the Prophecy Club.
Hey, Stan, good to be back with you.
I quoted Jeremiah 51, verse 9, "We would have healed Babylon, but she would not be healed. Forsake her and let every man return into his own country." And surprisingly, or maybe I should say not surprisingly, you said you agreed this is the time when America could be healed. So tell us more about what you had on your heart.
Sure. You know, there's a lot of praying going on right now for this country. There's a lot of people that don't believe that we need to be praying for this country. And you probably have faced many of these folks. You know, they just say it's everything is doomed and we are just going to be judged by the Lord. But I happen to believe differently, Stan. I believe that the future is not etched in stone as far as a timeline is concerned. You know, sure, there's many things going on in this country that have deserved and do deserve the judgment of the Most High. But as far as that is concerned, I don't agree with most of these naysayers. I do believe in the power of prayer, the power of repentance, the collective repentance of God's people. According to 2 Chronicles 7:14, if my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven and heal their land. And that is in the Bible.
That's
right. You cannot remove that from the Word of God.
That's right.
And so what a lot of people don't understand is that it doesn't take the whole country to repent. It is His people. His people need to repent and turn from their wicked ways and repent on behalf of those that don't know how to repent, that don't know how to turn to the Lord. So I believe in that, first of all. So I do believe there's a lot of prayer going forth in many, many parts of the country and many parts of the world, as a matter of fact. We have started under the direction of the Holy Spirit. He spoke to me in the year 2014, the beginning of 2014, and He said, the time of warning is over. It's time to reap the harvest and prepare my people for my return. So I said, what are you talking about, Lord? He said, it's time to bring in the harvest, son. And so I have begun doing conferences all over the country. We have done already 6 conferences, and many people getting healed, many people getting saved. I see a revival of major proportions coming to America. So, and we also, another thing we did was he instructed me to begin to put together intercessory prayer teams, IPT, we call them IPT, and we have battalions where we put intercessors together praying at least once a week in groups of 7 or 8 or maybe a little more. We give them the agenda. They have a set pattern to pray and intercede. We have given the warfare tools to pray. So we've been doing a lot of prayer around the clock every day of the week. There are others, of course, other groups praying. I know you all pray, and there are Amen. Other groups praying. I believe that this is having an impact. It is changing the momentum of the evil tide. This election is going to be very pivotal. There is something going on in the Republican elections. Of course, we have Donald Trump and Ted Cruz. Both of them would be okay candidates. They're both conservative. They have said many things that are good for the country. I do believe that Trump is a little more what the nation needs because he is going to clean house. If he gets into office, he's going
right.
to clean house.
Right.
And I don't agree with many of his of the way he does things.
Right.
He may some people say he's too abrasive, he's, you know, blah blah blah, whatever. I agree with all that, but we are in a crisis, Stan.
Yes.
We are this nation is at a crisis.
Yes.
And if we don't have someone in there that goes in there and cleans house.
That's right.
And begins to do set things in order. May not be the best way. It may not be the best choice, the best solution. But as long as it begins, I think we have a good chance of stopping this judgment of the Lord. Maybe have more years. Maybe have a few more years.
Absolutely. I know a lot of people listen to me and they say, you know, you're always so negative. Well, look, man, I am doing my best. If we can get people informed enough, scared enough, praying enough, repenting enough, I'd like to think that we could put this thing off another 4 years, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. Every year we can put it off that judgment has not arrived, then praise God. I'm not looking for it to happen. I desire that we would all prosper and be in health. Amen?
That's right. The Bible is full of examples. Look at Nineveh. Nineveh, the people repented, the judgment was withheld for a season.
Right.
Look at Hezekiah. Hezekiah repented.
15 years.
Yes. And so we see a lot of these examples in the scripture. So it is scriptural. It is not something where we are inventing or just pulling out of thin air. No, it is scriptural.
Okay, let me ask you a question. Let me ask you a question specifically about Trump. One of my congregation members came up and said, would you please tell me what you think of Cruz and Trump? And I thought, I need to do this on the air. But first, you. What do you think of Trump? Why do you think he's the man for the office?
There are only two candidates, really, that have stayed until the end.
Right.
Most of the other candidates, by the way, that just fell by the wayside, they were establishment people.
Right.
The people of this nation finally are awakening. They are seeing things clearly. They realize that the establishment... And when we say establishment, is people that are from inside the government. They're part of the good old boys group. The American people have wakened up. They are beginning to smell the coffee, and they are saying, you know what? We need to clean house. We need to clean house. I believe that, again, I am not endorsing Trump. I'm not saying he's a great guy. He's the best man for the job or whatever. But at this time, amongst those that are running, I think that he probably has the best chance to win the nomination against Hillary Clinton and clean house. And by that, I mean set this house in order, set many things in this country that are out of control, that they're out of place, they're out of alignment, to set it back in place.
Well, let me address my question then, and you can continue to comment. But as far as, yes, he is a little brash, he is a little off the cuff, but to me, I don't want a polished politician in there that is exactly polished and says all of the right things. I want a man of the people. I want someone that is not bought and paid for. In any way you want to cut it, all the rest of them have been bought and paid for by the fact that people are giving them money. The borrower is subject to the lender, meaning when Cruz takes this money, directly or indirectly, he's accountable to report to them on what he did with it. And by Trump not taking money, that to me tells us that he can really do something. Plus, as a businessman, I think he can go in there and clean house, straighten up a lot of things, get a lot of things done. Now, he said 2 Corinthians instead of 2 Corinthians, so that tells us he really doesn't know the Bible very well. But I think that God has raised him up for a season to be a possibility to turn this nation around. What do you think?
I agree. As a matter of fact, something very strange happened, Stan. I believe in prophetic signs. I truly believe in that. I am always looking for signs from the Lord daily. I recently was in Ohio, and I was ministering in church there. And on Sunday morning, I ministered, and there was a young woman with a little baby in her arms. And my wife was with me, and as I was ministering to her, I said, what is the child's name? And when she answered, it just blew me away, because I had been talking about this on the radio and with friends of mine. She answered and said, his name is Cyrus. And
yes.
I said, oh, yes. My Lord. I said, are you serious? Is the baby's name Cyrus? And she says, yes. And I have been talking about that very topic recently, that the Lord is raising up a Cyrus.
Okay,
just
and we
like
got to explain
in
what we're talking about.
Israel.
Cyrus was a king over in Mesopotamia, which is today Iran, and yet he told the Jews, go over and build their temple, and he was totally behind it, financed the whole thing. In other words, there is a time when a man that is not necessarily a man of God does godly things. Is that what
absolutely.
You're basically saying?
Absolutely, absolutely. Cyrus was a heathen. He was a heathen. He did not believe in the God of the Jews, of the Israelites, and yet he helped them. He held them, and he withheld the tide of evil that could have come in. I have been dealing with this topic, and I believe that Donald Trump may be that man, Cyrus.
I agree.
There is something going on, Stan, that people need to understand. There is a revolution going on in this country right now. Now, it is a silent revolution. It is not a violent revolution. But John F. Kennedy made a comment when he was president way back. He said, those that make peaceful revolution impossible make violent revolution inevitable.
Oh, Yeah,
and this is what the establishment is trying to do. They don't realize, and if there is any establishment people listening to this, listen to what I'm saying. This nation is trying to make a point. This is a peaceful revolution going on right now.
Yes, yes.
It's peaceful. They are voting not with guns. They are voting with ballots, with their votes.
Yes.
And they're trying to make a statement. And if you, as the establishment, continue to hinder that and try to squelch that and stop that from the mouth of John F. Kennedy, a violent revolution will become inevitable.
Terry Bennett was quoted as saying, the United States will go through civil conflict, civil war, then invasion. I still want to stop it, or at least delay it, if I can. I mean, that's the whole point of it. I mean, as a watchman, that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to warn the people and get them to turn from their sin. We aren't wanting, and there's too many people out there wanting to see bad come. I don't want to see bad come.
That's right. You know, I believe, Stan, and I know you have done a lot of teaching and you have experience on this as well as I do. And a lot of people don't understand this. Like Terry Bennett and many other prophets receive things from the Lord, and that's fine. They are true messages from the Lord. However, the way I see these things sometimes, and people don't agree with me, and that's fine. They have a right to disagree. Visions and dreams are given by the Most High many times, not 100% of them, but many times, most of the times, they are given so that we can intervene and stop it.
Thank you. Thank you. I've said that so many times.
We'll be right back after this message.
Order 2014 to 2021. It's the predictions of two cows and 13 modern prophecies. As Joseph interpreted Pharaoh's dream, I interpret these signs and prophecies to present a picture of what you can expect from 2014 to 2021. Now remember, all of this is in the mouth of two or three witnesses. The topics are September 25th, 2014, and how it starts the last 7 years of plenty. Then from the years 2022 to 2028 will be the seven-year tribulation. That's a very big statement. Then welfare checks will stop. Protesters start burning the cities. Martial law then declared. Obama stays in office. The Constitution suspended. Local militias formed to combat the Obama men. Gun confiscation is then ordered. That starts the internal revolution spoken of by Dmitry Dudeman. Then Russia attacks America in a surprise nuclear attack. Then Christian martyrdom begins. It's 2.5 hours of some of the most important information in the last 20 years of this prophecy ministry. Call 785-266-1112 or prophecyclub.com. It's called 2014 to 2021. Call 785-266-1112 or prophecyclub.com. Order today. Dr. Bree Keaton just made a brand new DVD on explosive prayer strategies. Power prayers that work. Not only does she hold two doctorates, prayer walked in 40 countries, author of 8 books and DVDs, but this little lady was sent by God to the deepest, darkest jungles of the Congo, where she found, rescued, and led 60,000 pygmies to Jesus. Machine guns fired at her. Machetes chased her. She was hunted like an animal, yet her prayers have kept her alive. In this DVD, you'll learn how to transcend barriers of hindered prayers, new ways to pray, learn to redeem the time in prayer, and how to transform your food through prayer, emergency prayers that really work, and how to stand in the gap. We normally ask a gift of $30 for our DVDs, but you can call Prophecy Club, 785-266-1112, and give a gift of any amount. Order today.
And now, back to the program.
Thank you. I've said that so many times. I said God is not above turning a Nineveh into a 40-year judgment instead of a 40-day judgment. God is not above turning a Jonah into a false prophet because his heart is not to kill, steal, and destroy. His heart is to push people toward Jesus. His heart is to see people repent.
There's a lot of people that do not understand that there's a lot of ignorance out there, Stan, and you know that. There's a lot of ignorance, people that don't know that, you know, self-proclaimed prophets, maybe God starts using them, they really begin to receive things from heaven, but they have never been trained, they have never been taught, they have never sat under godly teaching of a man of God or a woman of God that is knowledgeable, that
and they just make mistakes.
That has wisdom.
They just make mistakes.
Yeah, so everything they receive, they take it as, you know, thus saith the Lord, this is going to happen, and no one can stop it. And that is not true. There are some things that can and should be stopped.
And I'm glad they are stopped.
Yeah.
I mean, I believe that we stopped a series of suitcase nukes. Of course, you know, our listeners know what I'm talking about. But I want to see this stuff stop. Now, back to our point here. I believe Jeremiah 51, verse 9, may be in process right now, which says, we would have healed Babylon, but she would not be healed, forsake her, and let every man return into his own country. It may very well be that this is America's big chance. I don't want to say hopefully not last chance, but it may be America's biggest and best chance to get a repentance, get a turnaround. If we can pray and fast, and if we can get righteousness into the White House, and again, I believe that Trump is the best guy, not because I'm not a political guy. I'm not trying to say go vote for Trump. I'm more than that. I'm trying to say pray and fast that if he's elected, he's not stopped by some insider group, some conspiracy, some evil in high place. So that, in other words, if Trump could get in, he could start cleaning out the nest of spiders and snakes and start giving us a chance to get the gospel out, the truth on radio and the truth in our news programs, the truth in many places. And maybe, just maybe, maybe he could help a big revival to take place.
Yeah, I agree. And as a matter of fact, I believe that is where we are heading. I believe truly with all of my heart that we are going to see a tremendous revival, not just in this nation, many, many nations of the earth, before this whole thing is wrapped up.
Absolutely.
I do believe, and this is where we need to pray, when this nation is taken down, okay? And it will happen, because it's in the Bible, and this nation has been defiled by these people on purpose, because they know that if they can defile a nation with all these idols, look at what they're going to do in New York, building that arch. I mean, all these idols being built all around the nation, the abominations of same-sex marriage, the abortions, all these laws that have been passed and things that have been done have defiled the country.
Right.
And so as the country is defiled, what it does is it basically gives a license to the devil to come in here and bring all his hordes of hell and take over. That's basically what is going on. And this is how these people are doing it. By defiling a nation, they basically are taking God out of the equation, where the Lord is basically has no choice but to, you know, leave the nation to its own devices and, you know, and just withdraws. He withdraws, he backs off, and removes his hedge of protection, basically, is what he does when these things happen. So this is not really as people think it is. It's not God just, you know, bringing down judgment with a hammer. It's not like that. His judgment happens most of the times when he just withdraws. He backs off. His hedge of protection is taken off, and he says, is that what you want? Have at it. You know, the nation is defiled, and so he has no choice. And so these people know this. They're doing this on purpose. They are basically just shutting down the doors for the Lord to be able to intervene. And this is our last chance. I truly believe that. Now, this man Trump, and you asked me and you mentioned, I am not a political guy either. I don't tell people who to vote for, but I do point out certain things. There are certain things that this nation needs to address. One of them is the economy. I don't believe any of these other people that are running for office know how to fix the economy.
Amen.
This guy knows.
Yeah.
This guy, one thing he does know is he's an economic genius. This guy is very brilliant.
Right.
Now, I mean, everybody has said that, not just me. Everybody has said that.
Yep.
Secondly, this nation has to shut down its borders.
Yep.
This is the only candidate that has been saying that. Nations that fail to secure their borders will eventually be destroyed.
That's just right.
A fact. It's just, that's the way it is. No nation that has unsecured borders will end up well.
And let me also point out that that's exactly against the plans of the New World Order. They want to meld Canada and United States and Mexico all together in one global region. They don't want borders. So everything that Trump is for is actually against the New World Order.
Exactly. And this is why, Stan, they cannot allow him to get into the White House. This is why they're backing even Ted Cruz, whom they dislike with a passion. But he is a better alternative than Donald Trump, and they don't want him in there because they know he's going to clean
right.
house. He's going to come after all the things that Hillary Clinton did in Benghazi, Bill Clinton.
That's right.
And many of these other people have done horrible, horrible things, and he's going to go after them. So these are unspoken rules that he is going to break. They are not going to allow that. So what I see possibly happening, and this is something that the Lord showed me. He showed me back in October of 2012, I had an experience where I was told that a revolution was going to come to America
right.
that was going to usher in the New World Order.
Right.
I was in a very large, well-lit room with a wall-to-wall bookcases full of books and documents. I don't know where this took place. It could have been a heavenly place. It could have been here on the earth, a place I don't know of. I don't know. But I know that there was a small group of men, which I believe were angels, okay, messengers of the Most High, and were explaining to me the plans, the processes, and the history of the elite, the establishment. They began to methodically explain to me how they were behind all these events that have taken place in history. And they began to show me maps and information containing all of this information. As I was listening to them tell me these things, I was astounded at the brilliance and the wisdom and the plans and methods of these people. They have done this over centuries to bring about their evil goals. So their desire is they want to remain hidden. They don't want to be exposed. This is why they dread Donald Trump. They
right.
just dread him because
right.
he's going to expose them. And by the way, that is how we are praying. And if you want to know how to pray, people of God, pray that the evil plans of the enemy be exposed.
Yes.
Completely exposed and revealed. And that is how they're going to come down. So I began to see these things. As I began to see this thing, I was shown in detail how they have manipulated world events. They have devised plans and agendas in America, in many parts of the world, so they can take control and power over those areas. I was shown how the evil seed of the evil one has countless times in the past concocted behind closed doors their evil plans to destroy, exterminate, and commit genocide on the righteous seed of the Heavenly Father.
Man.
So these are demonized or demonic beings whose only aim is the destruction of the ways of God and His people. As I was listening to them, and I was amazed the things I was being shown and I was hearing, all of a sudden one of the men approached me and said to me in the loud voice as he looked at me in my face, in my eyes, this is what he said. There is going to be a revolution in America, and it will usher in a new world order.
There you go.
And as I heard this, I was awakened. And many pieces of the puzzle began to come together, and it began to make sense to me. Now, here's what I feel may happen, Stan, if the people of God do not pray and intercede. If we do not achieve a victory and we don't have a breakthrough in the spiritual realm and through our prayers and intercessions and warfare, this is what I believe will happen in the fall, okay, when we get to the presidential elections. Well, starting actually at the Republican convention. If these people try to take down Trump, in other words, if they try to deny him the nomination, there is going to begin a revolution. There's going
yep.
to begin a lot of unrest on this nation. There's going to be riots. There's going to be bloodshed.
Yep.
There's going to be a lot of things happening in the streets when people begin to go out and because they don't care anymore. They know that if this is done by the establishment, by the elite, and they deny the people, they're basically telling the people, your vote is worthless.
Right.
We do whatever we want. And if that happens, I truly feel, Stan, that there is going to be a revolution in America. And we are not even going to get to November elections. We may not even get there. We may not even get there. Now, the other option is when the Republican convention takes place, these people back off and they say, okay, we cannot do this. we cannot deny Trump the nomination because we're going to have a severe backlash. So we'll give him the nomination, okay? So he's nominated for the Republican Party to go against Hillary Clinton. So here comes November. Is Hillary Clinton against Trump? Now, they are going to back Hillary at this time. And again, this is another scenario that could play out. If they try to steal the nomination from Donald Trump, and you know, by many different means possible, by the ballot box, by doing stealing the you know the votes in the states and whatever.
Yeah, how are they going to do it?
Oh yeah. They have. Well, that's what they did in Utah. They brought in a system, a voting system from Venezuela that they could manipulate the votes. That's exactly what they did there in Utah.
Oh, really?
So this is another scenario that could turn out. And if this happens, we're also going to see a revolution. So this is, I believe, something that is playing out. We have the Bernie Sanders crowd, which are socialists, communists, the Hillary Clinton crowds, which are socialist fascists. And this goes along with the vision given to Dmitry Dudeman.
Right.
Years past, where he said that it's going to start with an internal revolution, started by the communists. Well, here we have two candidates in the Democratic Party, Sanders and Clinton, that are both communist socialists. So we have the scenario, it's in place.
We've got to interrupt right there because this was a 90-minute conversation. We'll continue this tomorrow if we have enough time. If you want to get all 44 dreams and visions that Augusto has been given, then you can do that by calling 785-266-1112. It's available on the internet for a gift of $30, but you can call 785-266-1112 and it's available for a gift of any amount. Also, his Smile Jesus Loves You, which is all of his dreams and visions, prophetic words, and also his testimony. That's normally available for $15, also available for a gift of any amount. 785-266-1112, End of Times DVD, or Smile Jesus Loves You book. Thank you for listening, thank you for your prayers, and thank you for your gifts of support. God bless. Now from the Prophecy Club, some exciting opportunities for you. Prophet Ephraim Rodriguez was shown in a vision that a large meteor will hit near Puerto Rico, causing a 1,000-foot tsunami. But by the time it hits the eastern seaboard of America, it will be from 200 to 400 foot high, going inland from 20 to 100 miles. It also hits an earthquake fault running up the Mississippi River Valley, splitting the Great Lakes all the way down to the Gulf of Mexico, and causing much of the West Coast from California to Alaska to fall into the ocean. Knowing that he was coming, I did some research, and I found 6 people who saw a large meteor hit near Puerto Rico, 5 people who saw a tsunami hit the eastern seaboard of the United States, 7 people saw America split in 2 pieces, 4 people saw large chunks of California fall into the ocean, and 9 people saw that all of this came because America split Israel. And I made a DVD on that called Meteor, The Destruction of America. Both DVDs valued at $30 each, a value of $60. But call Prophecy Club right now, 785-266-1112. Give a gift of any amount and get both of these very important DVDs. Catastrophe, Meteor, Tsunami, and Earthquake. Meteor, The Destruction of America. Valued at $60 for a gift of any amount. Call 785-266-1112. 785-266-1112. Order today.